What's up guys, Matt Day here, and today we're going to be talking about scanning Polaroids with this impossible scan adapter. Now I bought this back in 2013, and unfortunately they don't make them anymore, and they're pretty hard to find. I couldn't find any on eBay, but I want to talk today about why you should pick one up if you come across one, why it's useful, and also if you can't find one, how you can kind of make your own. But before we do that, I'm going to take a quick second to talk to you guys about our sponsor today, which is Skillshare. Skillshare is an amazing online platform full of classes from all kinds of people, including photographers. It's a place where you can learn more about your passion, pursue your passion into possibly making it your career, or just learn more. There's nothing wrong with that. And there are a lot of great classes by great photographers, people like Andre Wagner, Elizabeth Weinberg, Dan Rubin, Stephen Venasco. There's tons of great classes that I've personally taken and I love. And the great thing about all this is Skillshare is offering a free subscription to my subscribers. So all you have to do to take advantage of this is sign up in the link in the description of this video, and you're going to get 2 months entirely free of their premium subscription. Now, this scan adapter is literally just this big sheet of plastic. There's not much to it. Basically, you have four little cutouts where it's recessed a little bit that you can set your Polaroid down in there, and it has these little adhesive patches so that way it can actually grip the Polaroid and it doesn't slide all over the place as you put this in your scanner. It also includes these little holes here so that way whenever you're trying to remove the Polaroid, you can just push up on the bottom of it and lift it out that way. Makes it easy to grab, and that's really all there is to this thing. It's really, really simple, and it's really useful, and that's mostly to get rid of Newton rings. Now, if you don't know what Newton rings are, they're these annoying, extremely difficult to remove marks that you get on your scans from the plastic actually pressing against the glass of your scanner. It's really, really hard to avoid that if you don't have something to fix it, and it's even harder to try and get rid of it in post. So the reason that you buy one of these things is to get rid of that. So what it does is, because it's recessed and your Polaroid is sitting a little bit further back than the lip of this thing, what it's going to do is keep your Polaroid from being pressed against the glass so hard, and you're not going to get any of those marks. So it's really, really convenient for that. But like I mentioned, I bought this back in 2013 and they don't make them anymore, and it's pretty hard to find. But the nice thing about it is the fact that this is such a simple design, it could easily be replicated. I think the simplest way to make something like this and the most cost-effective way would probably be to take something as simple as like foam core or maybe some thicker cardstock, and actually just take two pieces, make a couple of cuts, and basically sandwich them together. That way your top layer is sticking out a little bit further from where your Polaroids are going to be sitting, and that's going to keep things from, you know, pressing the Polaroid into the glass and giving you those Newton rings. I haven't made one of these myself. I'll probably try and make one just for the sake of this video or something. But you know, it's a really, really simple idea, and it's just, I had these two lying around from, you know, prints and shipping prints and stuff. I always have some foam core lying around. So you could probably make something as simple as that. In order to keep the Polaroids actually sticking, you know, like on the actual scan adapter, we have this adhesive here. You could probably just take some double-sided tape, slap it on the back of the Polaroid, and then place it in the cutouts that you made. And that should work just fine. But we're gonna go ahead and get this thing going. What we're gonna do is scan in four images, since that's how many this can hold. And I just grabbed four random Polaroids from my big box of Polaroids. No particular reason, I just thought they would be fun ones to share. The first one here, portrait of my buddy Galen. This is a, not sure exactly which film stock this was. It was expired when I bought it from Impossible. They had it marked down crazy cheap, but I like the way that film looked. Next up, we have some Impossible PX70 color protection. I believe that was the name of it. I loved that film, but it's a Polaroid of a bear that I shot whenever Molly and I were in Tennessee several years ago. We were driving through Cades Cove, and there was a wild bear and this little bear cub that just came coming right across the road, and I managed to open up the car door and shoot this with my SX70 real quick, and then immediately shut the car door. Thought it was just kind of funny to have a Polaroid of a bear. Not every day you get to do that. The next photo is a photo of my buddy Castle. This was in North Carolina on a trip, and Castle has these crazy blue eyes, and he had this blue ski mask as well, and I just thought it made for a cool photo. And then finally, we have another photo of my buddy Castle, and this was actually shot with the very first release of Impossible Project film, way back when. It was just a black and white film. As you can tell, over the years, it has turned very, very brown, super soft, but still it's cool to have from their very first official release. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and just stick these Polaroids right on the scan adapter. This particular model was made for the 600 or SX70 type film. They did make another one for the Spectra size film, but I don't have that one because I've never really been that big a fan of Spectra size, but it's a little bit wider, so it's not gonna fit just right here. But luckily, things like Instax wide film, that's also about the same size as this, just a different, you know, format, and it's actually gonna fit just fine in this as well. So you can use that film here. You can also fit the FP100C and you know, Polaroid pack film, the peel apart film. You can also put that in here, basically just as an easier way to lay everything out in a pretty routine kind of you know, order. But you're not actually gonna be avoiding Newton rings with that film, because with that film, it doesn't have this layer of plastic over the top, so it's not actually gonna give you Newton rings. You can just throw that straight down on the scanner and you'll be fine. But like I said, throw it all on here. What I like to do is kind of make sure everything is lined up the same way. So the actual cutout area, it's actually gonna be a little bit bigger than the Polaroid, just so that way it's not gonna be, you know, smashing your Polaroid to fit in there. But I try to put everything down at the bottom right corner, and I'll explain why in a minute. But all of my frames, I just try to make sure they're lined up as flush as possible on the bottom and right here. So I just really focus on getting that right corner down nice and tight. That way everything is going to be consistent whenever I actually go to scanning, because doing this can really help save some time. So I line everything up just like that. Some of these are not sticking as well as they used to. They recommend just rinsing this in some lukewarm water and letting it air dry. Over time, there just gets more and more dust stuck to that adhesive there, but they say if you clean it, you know, it'll be working just good as new again. But I've actually never cleaned this thing, and I bought it way back in 2013. So it does work really well, even if you aren't so you know, particular about constantly cleaning it. But what I'm gonna do is set it actually here in the scanner. I'm scanning this on my Epson V600. This is the only scanner I have, so I use this for 35 medium format and Polaroids. So I still get a lot of questions about that. People think I'm still scanning on the Pacon, but I haven't used that in years after I sold it. So V600, we're gonna be using Epson scan software, super straightforward. But just like this, how I made sure all of the Polaroids were actually lined up just right in the bottom right corner, what I'm gonna do is press this in the top right corner all the way here in the back of the scanner. That way, every time I lay this in there, my outlines are gonna be, you know, consistent. And again, I'll get more to that once we're actually in the software. But we're gonna go ahead and lay this down, straight down. And there we go. Go ahead and fold it down. You can also use compressed air to just kind of give everything one hit of air. That way it's not gonna have any extra dust in there, but I've already done that before this, so I don't really have to worry about it. But if you're gonna be scanning anything, having compressed air to get rid of dust, that's a big help. So scanner's already turned on, so we're gonna go ahead and open up Epson scan. Now in Epson scan, I keep my settings pretty consistent for just about everything. Image type, I'm gonna have on 48-bit color. Resolution 600 dpi. This seems like overkill, and I totally get that. A lot of times if you're gonna be scanning this stuff, you might just be sharing it online, which that is plenty big for a Polaroid. But sometimes I like to print my Polaroids. So I actually did a show several years ago where it was all just scans of Polaroids that I shot. And it has a really cool look to see something like that blown up a little bit. And I just made everything 12 by 12 inch prints, and I scanned everything at 600 dpi, and that was plenty for that. So that is an option if you wanna scan stuff like this. It's not taking up that much space on your hard drive, and it really doesn't take that long to scan 600 dpi on stuff like this. And the way I look at it is, if I have it big enough to do something like that, I don't have to rescan later. So everything I scan Polaroid wise is always just 600 dpi. Down here, unsharp mask, all that is turned off. Descreening, color restoration, backlight correction, none of that stuff I use. If I wanna make any adjustments in post, I can do that. Add sharpening if I need to. The unsharp mask, I always leave unchecked on this scanner just because I think it over sharpens things. So we're gonna go ahead and hit preview, and it's gonna go ahead and do its little preview scan here, and then we're gonna see all the images off here to the right. And there we go. So this is important with lining everything up, like I mentioned, because what I'm gonna do is basically select an area just a little bit bigger than the actual frame itself, and I'm gonna crop that out later. But the reason I do this, whenever I set everything like this and leave myself a tiny, tiny bit of room, and I know exactly where I line everything up on that holder, what I'm gonna be able to do is say I have, you know, 40 Polaroids that I need to scan for a YouTube video here, or if I'm just scanning in a bunch to share online, what I can do is just go ahead and line everything up in the bottom right corner of the holder and then line everything up in the back right corner on the scanner. And every single time, all of these little, you know, basically selected areas that I make myself like this, every single time the Polaroid is gonna lie within that area. And I'm not scanning a ton of wasted space there, but everything is gonna fall in line with each of these little selected areas that I've made. And that just means every time I can just go ahead and, you know, take the Polaroids out, throw some new ones in there, slide it back, and just hit scan. I don't need to do this little, you know, drag and selecting an area every single time I'm doing it. So this really, really speeds up my workflow, and that's why I line things up like that. But now we've got everything selected, we're gonna go ahead and select all, go over here to scan. I've already made a folder where everything is going, and now it's gonna go ahead and scan everything in. Now, one thing I've noticed with Epson Scan that I'm just gonna go ahead and throw in here, and maybe someone else is experiencing this, I've noticed that with this software lately, it's like I have to be here at all times and making sure I'm clicking on the scan software and, you know, making sure I'm waking it up and letting it know to go to the next frame. I have no idea why it does that. It never used to do that, but when I'm scanning a roll of 35 millimeter, I have to be here frame to frame as it scans and make sure I'm clicking on it to make sure the scanner keeps going. If anyone else is having issues with that, please let me know, because it's crazy frustrating. But that's it, everything is done. We went ahead and scanned everything in. I've made a Polaroid scans folder over here, and here we go. We have all of these different files here. Let's go ahead and open these up. Let's just do a quick look here. There we go. We've got our scans in. Like I said, there's a little bit of an area outside of the frame that we'll have to crop out, but that's super easy to do. From here, if I wanted to do anything, I could toss them into Lightroom, crop things out, make my adjustments, and that's really all there is to it. After that, I export everything at the full resolution to Dropbox, and if I ever want to have something on Instagram or anything like that, I can just pull it on my phone, and there it is. So that's pretty much it on my scanning process for Polaroids. I hope it was helpful for you guys. I've been getting a lot of questions lately, so I figured I would go ahead and address it. But if you have any other questions, feel free to leave those in the comments below. And if you decide to make your own scan adapter like I showed in this video, definitely let me know how that works for you. I hope it serves you well, because those Newton rings are really, really annoying, and trying to avoid them any way possible is definitely recommended. So thank you guys for everything. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.